So friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this verbal reasoning session, we are going to discuss about puzzle test. Okay, even in campus placement written test, the questions from puzzle test will be appearing. So this is also most demanded topic. Let's begin with an example for easy understanding. Let's see a paragraph first. 6 persons. A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. 6 persons. A, B, C, D, E, F. Are sitting in 2 rows. Are sitting in 2 rows. 3 in each. 3 in each. Okay. In 2 rows. 3 in each. Okay. Now, let's see what are the conditions given. E is not at the end of any row. Okay, next condition is D is second to the left of F. Okay, next. C, the neighbor of E, is sitting diagonally opposite to D. Next, B is the neighbor of F. Let's analyze this first. Okay, E is not at the end of the row. This is first condition. Second condition is D is second to the left of F. Okay, D is second to the left of F. C, the neighbor of E, is sitting diagonally opposite to D. B is the neighbor of F. Okay, this is the condition. Like, these four are the given conditions. Let's see first question. Okay, first question is, which of the following are sitting diagonally opposite to each other. Let's see the options. Okay, who both are sitting diagonally opposite to each other. Let's see at the options. Okay, first option is FC, second option is DA, third option is A and C, fourth option is A and F, and the fifth option is A and B. Okay, these are the options given. Now let's look and analyze the answer. Okay, first let's draw all these four conditions. Okay, he is not at the end of 2 rows, so he will never be at this position. Okay, this is end position. First row end position, second row end position. E will never be at the end position. Next is D is second left of F. Okay, if D is second left of F, okay, if this is F, this will be D. If this is F, this will be D, because D is the second left of F, as well as this. This is first row, this is second row. Okay, next, C, the neighbor of E, is sitting diagonally to D. It is said that C is the neighbor of E. C is the neighbor of E. Okay, C is sitting diagonally to D. If this is D, C will be sitting here. If this is D, C will be sitting here. Okay. and C and D are side by side. It is said that C and D are side by side. So E will be either here. No, this will not be possible because this will be the dead end. E will be either in between C is the neighbor of E. Okay, so C will be here and E will be either the side of C because E's neighbor is C and C's neighbor is E. So C and E will be side by side and E will never be at the end of the row. This is one condition. Last condition is B is the neighbor of F. B is the neighbor of F. Okay. And now let's analyze F and C. F and C are never neighbors. Analyze all the conditions. You will only understand clearly. D and A are never neighbors because C is the neighbor of E. Okay, C is the neighbor of E and C is opposite to D. So DA is also not neighbors because we never discussed about A and D. So we are not sure whether they are neighbors. A and C, let's see how, okay. If this is A, this is B, and leftover option is F. This is wrong because here we got E as end of the row. So this is wrong. Let's try some other thing. A, E, C, B, D, F. Okay? No, this is also wrong because we clearly know that C is the neighbor of E diagonally opposite to D. So D and C should be diagonally opposite, but B is the neighbor of F. This condition is not satisfying because this both should be side by side, but here it is not happening. So this is wrong option. So this is also wrong. Next is AF. By analyzing, let's try AF. D will be diagonally opposite to C. Yeah, this is correct. So this is the final answer. So the solution is A and F. This is final answer. Like this we have to analyze when they give you puzzle. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell icon to get future notifications of my videos. Thank you so much for watching.